God bless you, greetings, and good day. We thank you for joining us at www.westdurhambaptist.org and also on our social media outlets via Instagram, YouTube, and also Facebook. We thank you for joining us today in our worship broadcast, and we pray that something will be said and done to encourage you during your daily walk during this time of this international global pandemic. Know that we are bringing worship to you. So as we go into worship today, join us at home. Join us if you still are at work, knowing that God is a God that inhabits the praises of his people. Again, thank you for worshiping with us. God bless you.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I was glad when it was better for me. Let us go into the house of the Lord. Let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. So glad to be able to worship God together on this Sunday morning. And as you join us in worship, let's lift up the doxology of the church. Praise God.
Come on, you know the Lord is good. Come on, put your hands together. We love the Lord. Hallelujah. Song says, you've been better to me than I've been to myself.
Yes, God.
You are good, and your mercy endureth forever. We give God praise for our music ministry. I'm going to be calling them back up today so that they can help me at the end. I'm not going to hold you long this morning preaching, but there is a word from the Lord. You've been better to me than I've been to myself. That's all I wanted to tell y'all today, that he's been good. Real good, and his mercy endures forever. Shall we pray in Jesus' name? Father, now in Jesus' name, we thank you for your grace and for your mercy. We pray, God, that you would now turpentine these lips of clay. Let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight and in the sight of these your people. Preach me, Holy Ghost, like never before. We pray this now in the strong name of Jesus, who is the Christ of Nazareth. And the people of God say, amen. Again, thank you to our youth pastor and his presiding as he has read our scripture today. Again, 1 Corinthians, the second chapter. This ninth verse, which so many Christians in the black church can quote, half of which don't know where it's at, but we know this. As it is written, I hath not seen, from the King James Version, nor ear heard, neither have it entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. I want to talk from the thought this morning. Looking ahead. It is that old mantra that has been used sometimes, that it's dangerous to try to drive forward while looking through the rear view mirror. And how many in this culture, in this time, in America and in the globe, have run afoul of life, have collided with the obstacles of circumstance, trials, and as we spoke on last week, tribulations. Not because there was not a clear path forged ahead, but because their focus was so keenly in what was left behind. Yes, even in this month of January, there are so many who will miss the blessing and opportunity and hope that lies within this year, 2021, because of all that we ran into last year. Jobs and industries decimated. Rearview mirror. Lives lost, and some more, unfortunately, will be. But those that transition and passed, the focus of who did it and who failed, rearview mirror. The kleptocacistocracy of a president, that word, a conjunction word of one who is a kleptomaniac who will steal to get ahead, thief and a robber. Kleptocracy, a government or governance by ones who are not qualified. I'm preaching already, y'all ain't said amen. And how we will be held up with a new president by dwelling on the ignorance of the last 4 years. Can't move forward until we adjust our vision, our sight, until we start looking ahead. And watch this, that's not that you don't, I like what the preacher said, that's not that you don't look back and reflect on where the Lord brought you from. But it is about the intent to go back from where the Lord brought you out of. I can't hear nobody pray. That so many of us, watch this, the Lord has brought us from a mighty, 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 mighty long way. And now that we are where we are, some of us can't help but say, child, I remember back when. But you don't tell the whole story about that. Yes, yes, you had some good times, but you also were praying for the Lord to get you where you are right now. You were praying for the Lord to open doors that God has opened, and for somebody, for God to make a way and to heal, deliver, and set free. And God has done that. And so oftentimes we move, here it is, from a place, preacher, of having faith to being satisfied with talking about faith. I've lost about 5 black folk in here. Many of us are good with talking faith. Talking, God's gonna do it, and singing, oh child, we come this far by faith. But then when reality hits and bills come and the prognoses are coming from doctors and lab results come in, we are then at a place where we cannot move from the talking about faith to the enactment of faith. And it's not that the road is not paved. It's not that God has not made a way for us. And watch this. And for many of us, it's not that we don't have a track record of God doing what God said he was going to do. But it's amazing, because sometimes we'll get selective amnesia concerning where the Lord has brought us from. And then we'll forget that simple saying. And from that song, there is no secret. What God can do, what he's done for others, he'll do for you. But listen, it's not just about what God has done for others. Many of us can testify, God has done the impossible for me before. I mean, if you're here, can you just lift your hand up and say, God has done the impossible for me before, that I've been there before, where I've looked at obstacles and said, I couldn't, it can't be done. And others look at you and say, you can't do it and it won't be done. But somehow you have the fortitude and the faith that after the pain, after the divorce, after the struggle, after the cancer, after the pain, after the rejection, you were able to get back up, shake the dust off, put another face on your face, put your hair in a ponytail, put some gloves and some sweat on, and get to work all over again. I wish I had somebody in here that says, even in a hard times, even in rough times, this ain't the first time. Even in my struggle, this is not the first time. I've been in a place where I said, God, if you don't do it, it can't be done. And so this is where you allow your past to connect with your present to push you into your future. Y'all will hear what I say. That's when you look back and say, God, if you did it for me last year, if you did this, oh, don't miss this, if you brought America out of great depressions, out of
They used to laugh at me and call me Four Eyes.
So I said, well, if y'all want to laugh at me, I'm going to make my 4 eyes look good. I can't hear nobody praying. So, and so I got used to just wearing glasses and looking good in my frames. And watch this one. And when I took them off, I realized that I couldn't see, because I can't see. Amen, somebody. Amen. But I know what my own vision is. Let me push this. If we're going to look ahead, we have to understand that faith looks beyond the temporal. I have not seen. There's a difference between being short-sighted and near-sighted. Uh-oh. You see, being near-sighted is actually an effect of your ocular system. It is called myopia. It means that you can only see things that are in front of you, that are close. But to me, there's a difference between being able to see things that are close and being short-sighted and not being able to see ahead. Come here, Zion. And there's too many churches that are so short-sighted that when trials come, they're not planning for after the pandemic. Help me, Holy Ghost. That our focus is on the here and now. And there were so many churches, West Durham, that did not make it through. I can't hear nobody pray, because they weren't looking past next Sunday's offering. They weren't looking past who was coming to church this week, because we were short-sighted. And there becomes, watch this, this myopic vision that has people of God at a point where we can't see further than what's in front of us right now. We'll come and sing and shout and then get home and look, or even on your phone, and look at a Duke notification and you done lost all your faith. I don't know what I'm going to do. Look a little further. Faith looks, I have not seen. And watch this, and so many of us, we want to shout this text, but we don't want to look at this text, because sometimes, watch this, we are trying to get people to see our vision through their eyes. Help me, Holy Ghost. That's why you got to be careful in this season who you're telling about what God has told you, because there are some people that are so short-sighted, they cannot see how God is going to take you from point A to point B, because they don't see what you see. You can't give a long vision to a short-minded person. And sometimes you got small-minded folk talking big talk, but you can't do big when little's got you. Faith looks beyond the temporal, I have not seen, but faith also looks beyond uncertain sound. I'm in the book. I have seen, have not seen, nor ear heard. Kevin Miller, former vice president of Christianity Today, once stated, most people prefer the certainty of misery to the certainty, misery of uncertainty. I'm going to read it again so y'all can hear it clearly. He said, most people prefer the certainty of misery than the misery of uncertainty. There's some people that are not going to move because there have been sounds that have scared them. There have been talk. There have been things, and we've listened to the wrong sounds. Instead of launching out on business, we'll listen to somebody that did not have a business plan and their business flunked. I can't hear nobody pray. That will give you a sound of fear when you've got a plan and a God and some money with some seed. I can't hear nobody pray to get you where you need to go. We'll listen to other people with the sound of misery that'll tell black folk you don't need to go to college, because the new trend is that other folk, y'all ain't gonna like what I'm gonna say, are able to have other industry jobs and don't need an education and can make $1 billion. I can't hear nobody pray. That's an uncertain sound. So you'll be miserable, uneducated, and okay. I can't hear nobody pray. And then instead of saying, God, whatever certification. I can't hear nobody pray. Your track may not be my track, but you ought to have something that you know you can rely and depend on. But as long as you're listening to the uncertain sound of miserable people, you'll always tune your ear to deafness. That's why you gotta be careful who you're listening to. I need somebody to hear me preach today. I don't care what God is doing with us here at West Durham. I don't listen to every preacher. What? I done lost about 5 of y'all. I don't listen to every report about what the churches are doing, because I know what God is doing here. And it comes a point in ministry. Here it is. But you've got to differentiate between what people are saying and what God is saying. I wish I had somebody in here that felt like I felt. We're going to say it in a little while. There comes a point in your life where you ought to say, Lord, speak to my heart. Where you say to yourself, listen, I can't listen to what everybody else is saying, what everybody else is doing. And I hear stuff like, child, I heard they had such and such going on over that church, and such happened because people were in charge. And whenever you have human frailty trying to move a divine organism without the leading of the divine, you are always certain to run aground. It has to be a place in our lives where we move from operating off of emotionalism to a place, don't miss this, I know this is kind of scary for church folk, where we are operating off of both fact and feeling. Come here. We can't pay our bills off of the moving of the Holy Ghost. I wish I had a church that helped me preach it here. We got to have more than what it feels. I praise God for our budget ministry. I praise God for our trustees here. I do. Because watch this. We got to have people in an organized life that says we can't just go and do whatever and just say, well, God's going to do it. No. Sometimes you got to count the cost and know the fact and then trust God. Y'all ain't got to like it, but I know I'm right. Sometimes you got to know how much house you can buy before you go around walking around somebody else's house and go to jail for trespassing. You got to know sometimes you got to fix some stuff so God can put you in the place God wants you to be. I'm going to get some hate mail from some preacher today, because yes, I know you can name it and claim it, but sometimes you got to prop it and fix it. Sometimes you got to fix what you got so God can allow you to be in what you're supposed to be in. And I thank God sometimes, hallelujah, I feel the Holy Ghost, y'all, for the ability to see ahead and get myself ready for where God's taking me. And watch this, every now and then, you got to understand there are people who only want to go off of feeling. Oh, here it is. I got a feeling. And I think that's why worship has become a mess in the church. It's because we've had praise and worship that we had to muster up. We had to get it. We had to, come on, y'all. Come on, worship. Come on, clap your hands. Come on, come on. We're going to get up a praise. The devil is a liar.
seance, we're not here to conjure up some ghost. If you've got the Holy Ghost, you ought to be able to have clapping in your hands and dancing in your feet. You ain't got to get me stirred up. When I walk up, God, I feel the Holy Ghost. When I got up this morning, I was already stirred up. When I put my feet on my carpet, I was able to say I was glad. When they said unto me, when I got up this morning, I was able to tell God, thank you, because I'm not just operating off of emotion. I've got some fact.
Listen, I didn't come to holler today, but I feel all right. What are you talking about? Listen, what has entered into the heart of man? Watch this. See, Sister Harriet, we got people who are still only shouting on faith. You've been in church for 1,000 years. I can't hear nobody pray. Preacher for 800 years in the same ministry on the same pew for 412 years. You've been in church all your life, and all you have is a faith. You miss me. There ought to come a place in your faith journey where your faith flips and becomes fact. Y'all still don't see it. Faith says, I was hoping I didn't have coronavirus. Y'all ain't gonna like this. I lost my smell while I was at Target. It left me. 9:45 at night. I was smelling some bath wash, because I believe the men of God ought to smell good and look good in Jesus' name. I'm trying. And I looked, Brother Jeff, and I smelled it, and I said to myself, Lord Jesus, they have forgot to put the fragrance in this body wash. I grabbed another one, another brand, and smelled it, and I had no smell. Don't miss me here. So I went home. Deacon David immediately isolated, not because I didn't have faith, but because I had enough facts that says this was a symptom. Y'all ain't got to like me in here, of the coronavirus. And here, my faith then went in overdrive because I had enough facts on my side. Y'all ain't gonna hear what I'm saying. That says this: out of all the people that have died, I still believe that God was able. And I had enough facts that said in 2002, when I should have died in a truck accident, the same God that brought me out then was the same God today. Now I wish I had somebody in here, and even at home, that I say I ain't got to wait till faith comes in, but I can shout on my facts that God is still a bridge over troubled water. God is still a doctor in the sick room. God is still a lawyer in the courtroom. And somebody ought to say that's a fact. I'm done. Faith looks beyond the temporal. Faith looks beyond the uncertain sound. Faith looks beyond the human emotion. And then faith rises above human expectation. I'm done. I'm going to put my Jake break on today, because I got to do this again for y'all next week. Listen here. When I got here to West Durham, a great church, had been through a low place. Whew. When I got here that Sunday, I'm gonna tell them myself. I counted, and there were 71 people. God, I felt like preaching today. And I sat here in the center seat. Didn't know y'all. Y'all didn't know me. I know it was a Baptist church, so we had to go through a process. But I declare, I saw what I was supposed to see. Wasn't nobody in the balcony, but I was preaching to folk in the balcony. There were only 71 people in here, but
flashing of silk. Have I got a witness in here? Sometimes what I'm trying to tell you is you've got to see what other folk can't see. And you got to rise above others' expectations. And I need to tell you that when I got here that first Sunday, I had to preach like it was revival. I know it was a Sunday morning, but I had to preach like it was revival, not because of a weeknight revival, but because revival says that I'll bring life again. And that's all I had to come to tell you, that when you learn how to look forward, you don't wait until it starts raining to bring out an umbrella, but you get ready for the manifestation before it comes. And I came to tell somebody that eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor has it entered into the hearts of them of men, for them that love God. And when you love God, God will do for you, Sister Nikki, what no other power can do. I didn't come here to holler today, but I feel alright, because sometimes you've got to say like the Clark sisters, I expect a miracle, not just on Sundays, but I expect a miracle every day. And I wish I had somebody in here that I lay hands on yourself and say, when you get home, lay hands on your house and declare, I expect.
solid word on this Sunday morning. That message ought to prick your soul to strive to have more faith in our God. My brother, my sister, under the sound of my voice, if you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ, we open the doors of the church for you right now. My brother, my sister, you're watching us on YouTube, you're watching us on Facebook, but wherever you are in your life, I encourage you right now to get to know Jesus for yourself. ABCs of salvation, admit that you're a sinner. Believe that Jesus Christ died for you. Confess him as your Lord and your Savior. And then you might say, preacher, I have a relationship with the Lord. I have accepted him as my Savior. I believe he died for my sins. I admit that I was born into a world of sin. But yet you don't have a church home. My brother, my sister, we offer this invitation for you to join the body of Christ here at Western. All you have to do is write there in that caption, right below, that I want to join Western. So wherever you are, you might not know Jesus Christ in the pardoning of your sins. You might need a church home. We offer this opportunity for you to make Jesus your choice and to join the body of Christ. Father God, I pray for that person, that man, that woman, that needs to build a relationship with you. I pray for that man, that woman, that needs to make you their Lord and Savior. God, I pray for that man, that woman, that needs to get into the body of Christ. God, I pray right now for somebody's soul. God, I pray for that man, that woman that needed to hear this word. God, strengthen our faith so that we will see what you want us to see. God, that we'll hear what you want us to hear. And God, we realize that there are so many great things that you have prepared for your people. God, we thank you for this word. We stand on it. Bless now in the strong name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You gave me my hands to reach out to man. Hallelujah. My will, I
keep on blessing your church.
Thank you for being consistent and faithful. Write to that threefold amen. Thank you for being consistent and faithful in your tithes and in your offerings. We don't know when we'll be able to come back physically, but as I say over and over again, when we do, just know we're saving a seat for you. So now receive the Lord's blessing and his impartation. You are blessed in the city. You are blessed in the fields. You're blessed in your going and in your coming. So I speak the blessing of the Lord into your life, and I declare you are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath. This is your mentality, that you are the lender and no longer the borrower. Now, may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit here at worship, as we brought worship to you via our website, www.westdurhambaptist.org, and also through our social media ministry. We pray something has been said and done to let you know, even online, you were in the right place at the right time. Know this, during this time of uncertainty in our country and across the globe, you have a church family. You have the Zacharias Ministry here and the West Durham Baptist Church that's praying for you. And until we gather again, God be with you.